you always got to give the glory to God for anything before you start anything. So right now, I want to give God the glory and the honor for bringing us together.
Yeah.
And it was funny because about a month ago, Bob's wife, because me and Uta, we always talk. We always go back and forth. You know, and she told me about the plan today. So I was thinking, oh, that's easy. I'll take care of it. Bond and we take care of work. So when I walked into the church, and I saw the worship group, and I was thinking, she doesn't belong in the church. Morgan Blair doesn't belong in the church. The other people doesn't belong in the church. And the worship group in the church. So I was thinking, wow, am I in the wrong church? But anyway, today is a special day. Bond, I've known Bond for a long time. When I was in the world, I used to work in a lot of clubs. And when I first saw this guy, he was very young, good looking guy. And I was thinking to myself, this guy, there's no way he's going to get into the club. He looked like he was only 16 years old. That's my first confrontation with him. So I kind of grabbed him when he first came into the club. He was green. He came in with a posse. Also, he wasn't even 16 years old. He came to the ghetto, Pete, brother Pete over there. And he wanted to get into the club. But they all came in, all these guys. And I'm like, you're going to have to stand on the corner. Let me talk to Bob. So Bob, like my sister Sophia said, Bob is one of those guys, really tall. And one good thing about this guy, actually speaks louder than words.
Amen.
And that's exactly how he is.
Yeah.
Today, I was trying everything I can, trying to hide everything that was going to. He didn't have no idea what I was doing. He thought, I'm just taking him out to me, which that's what we did. And we talk and we're talking, keep looking at the clock. And he had problems taking forever. So, it's funny because when I first found out that Rita was dating Bob, I was thinking to myself, why am I here? And Rita was dating Bob at the time, and I was thinking to myself, this guy is dating Rita? And I'm like, no. Let me refresh myself. Rita, Rosa's sister, Rosa's there is no way Bond would pick this girl. I told Bond, when you first marry Ruta, you're marrying the wrong one. I mean, you guys might think I'm kidding. I'm not kidding. Ruta, he's done everything he can to make everything worse between him and Uta. But Uta, she's like, you know, she's like one of those that, like what Pastor Puma said, never stop talking. Bob just lay back and kiss that. Nicest guy. He's one of the nicest guys. To me, I think he's the only nicest guy in the church right now.
Man.
But, you know, when we had lunch together, that's when, you know, Angela, my wife, hey, Angela, she got up and she went to use the restroom. And I was just listening to Bond, me and him, we share the word, we talk about the word, and praise. And I was thinking to myself, this guy, if something happens to these guys, he's going to go straight to heaven. Because the way I know Bob from the beginning, and still on TV, it's like 360. There's no way I can change this guy. There's no way I can drag him back to the past that he did. Because, like what I said, he was so strong in the word, and he's one of those guys that he watches what he says. You know, when I talk to him, I have a lot of respect for this guy. He has a lot of love for the church. He has a lot of love for his parents. He has a lot of love for his kids. But the thing is, you know, there are some things in life that you can't change. There's this guy right here, his heart. It's all about heart.
Yeah.
He always talked about Pastor Puna, the way church things are going in the church. Because I haven't been in this church since my wife passed away. And it's one of those when you marry a Palangi, I'm pretty sure Pastor Darcy right here knows how it is when you marry a different kind of outside of your culture. It's kind of hard. You know, I'm not trying to talk about my wife.